I'm very excited about it. I've heard it's very good. My lovely daughter here says it's fabulous, and we're excited to see it.
No way.
Yeah. Mm. I mean, of course, it's an animated film. Do you have a personal favourite from when you were a young girl yourself?
I think Aristocats was my favourite Disney movie when I was young. But also, one of my absolute favourites is Up. I think it's just beautiful, especially that first 20 minutes makes me cry. So I think animation is fantastic, it really is.
Speaking of fantastic, what are you up to yourself at the moment?
I am doing the fantastic Spamalot in the West End. I've just gone back into it. It's at the Playhouse Theatre. So, it's a lovely, lovely show. I'm enjoying it. But to come here on a Sunday morning is a little interesting.
Of course, I mean, a lot of fans out there will be familiar with Spamalot, but for anyone who isn't, can you tell us a little bit about the show and who you're playing in it?
I am playing the Lady of the Lake in Spamalot, which is Monty Python's Spamalot. It is the musical version of Monty Python and the Holy Grail, and it's a great, fun show. Very short, very funny, and come see it. It's great fun. You've seen it about 43 times, and it still doesn't tire.
I think a lot of young fans watching this are going to know, what's life really like in the West End? And would you give them, have you got any advice for them if they'd like to follow in your glorious footsteps?
Being in the West End is terrific, especially if you're in a show like Spamalot, because it's great fun and there's a great community spirit and a good cast. But ultimately, it's quite hard work too. So it's important that the West End is somewhere that is a pinnacle of achievement, and I'm very proud to be there.
What do you think distinguishes the West End from all the other theatre capitals in the world? What does set it apart?
One of the most wonderful things about being in London are the beautiful theatres. They're very gorgeous, they're entertaining, the standard is very high. Broadway is another centre of excellence for theatre, especially for musical theatre, but I think London is fast catching it up. And to be in London in the summer is always a really, really lovely thing, because there's so much to do and so much to see.
Bring it back to the show, Monty Python, adored around the world. What do you think the magic of their comedy is? Why do you think all these years later we're still enjoying it, particularly on stage like this?
Monty Python is timeless, because it's about adults being really silly, but it's very charming as well. So I think something like that is really good for all the family, because in fact the adults laugh probably more than the children do, but it's also, I don't know, it just appeals to everybody now. And it's very, as I say, timeless and fun and very British, so there is an eccentricity about it. Yeah, and I defy anyone who goes out of that theatre feeling miserable, because apart from anything else, we have Always Look on the Bright Side of Life as a song, which happens to be, I think, the most requested song at funerals. So I'm not saying you should come to a funeral, but I think it says a lot about the state of the song. It makes you feel good afterwards.